The following is a message from the next president of the United States, Senator Hillary Rodham Clinton.
Good evening, my fellow Americans. As we all know, this has already been a long, hard-fought campaign for the Democratic presidential nomination. But tonight, with my recent victory in Indiana and Senator Obama's in North Carolina, we remain exactly where we were 4 months ago, hopelessly deadlocked. Therefore, this nomination is going to be decided, as it should be, by the superdelegates, based not on primary results or caucuses or delegate counts or popular vote, but on their sober assessment of which candidate will be the strongest against Senator McCain in November. Tonight, I'm here to tell you why I am that candidate. First, I am a sore loser. If and when I am the nominee, I know, as do the superdelegates, that Senator Obama will work his heart out for my election. If, on the other hand, Senator Obama is chosen, I will probably refuse to campaign for him. Or, if I do so, it will be in a resentful, half-hearted way, thus ensuring his defeat, so that I can run again in 2012. You see, unlike my opponent, I'm just not going to lose gracefully. It's not a criticism of Senator Obama. It's just a fact. Second, my supporters are racist. If and when I am the nominee, Senator Obama's African-American supporters will be disappointed, perhaps, but they will still rally to me. If, however, Senator Obama is the nominee, my supporters will refuse to vote for him, partly because I will secretly tell them not to, but mainly because they are racially biased and would never vote for any African-American candidate. I'm not bragging. That's just the way it is. Now, to those of you that worry, if my opponent is denied the nomination, that African Americans might simply stay home, I remind you, A, until Senator Obama shockingly, and might I add rudely and selfishly, won the Iowa caucuses, most African Americans supported me. B, my husband was the first black president. And C, in the days ahead, we expect to receive the endorsement of America's preeminent African-American leader, Reverend Jeremiah Wright. Which brings me to my third and final argument. Unlike Senator Obama, I have no ethical standards. Even my critics would agree that once I get the nomination, I will stop at nothing, absolutely nothing, to win. Whereas with Senator Obama, there are some things he simply will not do. Take, for example, the race card, which he has been reluctant to play, as in, anyone who doesn't vote for me is a racist. I, on the other hand, will be happy to play the gender card and claim that anyone who doesn't vote for me is a sexist. In fact, once Senator Obama is out of the picture, I look forward to playing the race card myself. As in, anyone who doesn't vote for me is both a sexist and a racist. Now, to those of you who say, she'll never do that, it doesn't even make sense. I answer, if you believe that, then you don't know me. So there you have it. Sore loser, racist supporters, no ethical standards. Qualities Senator Obama simply cannot match. That's not an attack on my opponent. It's just the truth. When you consider that, the choice is obvious. Thank you, and live from New York, it's Saturday night!